Welcome to Let's Talk About It with your host, Lisa and Lizzie. I'm Lisa. And I'm Lizzie. Let's talk. Welcome to Let's Talk About It. Today, we are going to talk about depression and anxiety. This is a much-needed topic because most people experience feeling of depression and anxiety at times. You are right about that. Emotions such as grief, loss of a job, divorce, illness and other stressors can lead to feelings of sadness, worry, frustration and loneliness. All these are normal reactions to difficult situations we face. When a person is experiencing depression and anxiety, it can interfere with the ability to carry out everyday activities such as getting to work on time, proper self-care, or caring for children. You are right about that. Let's introduce our guest. Please welcome Dr. Drake. Thank you for joining us.
Always a pleasure.
Dr. Drake, could you tell us how a person would know if they are suffering from depression or anxiety?
If a person is suffering from depression, they will experience sadness, empty moods, feelings of hopelessness, feelings of guilt, worthlessness, helplessness, loss of interest in hobbies or activities they previously enjoyed. They will experience decreased energy or a feeling of being slowed down.
Wow, that's really terrible on a person's mental health. How would depression affect a person's physical health?
Physically, the person would have difficulty concentrating, making decisions or remembering. They will also experience insomnia or oversleeping, loss of appetite and weight loss, or overeating and weight gain, restlessness and irritability. Other physical symptoms they experience could be headaches or digestive disorders.
Wow, I'm getting depressed listening to the symptoms.
The worst part is, they have thoughts of death or suicide.
When people talk about depression, they often mention anxiety at the same time. How different are they? Are they basically the same?
Depression and anxiety can co-occur, that is why they are often talked about together.
What are some symptoms of anxiety?
Restlessness or feeling on edge. Other symptoms include easily fatigued, difficulty concentrating, mind going blank, irritable, muscle tension, sleep disturbance, and excessive worrying.
Those are very serious symptoms. Yes, they are. Anxiety and depression can strike anyone. Here is a clip from Good Morning America, talking to Selena Gomez about depression and seeking help.
Now with Selena Gomez, in a candid new interview, she opens up about seeking help for depression and how she got through a difficult year. Chris Connolly is in Los Angeles with the story. Good morning, Chris.
Good morning, George. And in doing so, Selena Gomez is again using her voice the way an increasing number of pop performers are, speaking forthrightly about their mental health issues and the help they're getting to address them.
So let's be crazy.
She's one of the planet's preeminent pop stars, now Selena Gomez, speaking candidly about her mental health, opening the window into the issues that last year led her to seek treatment for depression and anxiety.
Last year, I took a lot of time off. I think that I needed a moment to myself.
The 26-year-old singer and actress on a new podcast, advocating for treatment, not only for herself, but for others as well.
I'm a believer of therapy. One of my friends asked me, you know, I want to start going to therapy. And I said, it's good. Like, just tell me how your like first experience goes. And I said to her, you have to just give it a month.
She's now hoping her candor will inspire others to get the help that they need.
I do think that it's helped me understand myself and my childhood a lot better.
I personally could not be more delighted that Selena Gomez is speaking out about her mental health, about her treatment. It is doing volumes to reduce stigma.
She's among those performers opening up about their inner struggles and their need for self-care. Earlier in the week, this from Britney Spears, now spending what she calls me time at a wellness facility.
My family has been going through a lot of stress and anxiety lately, so I just needed time to deal.
Last month, Justin Bieber on Instagram explaining his decision to sit it out for a while. I am now very focused on repairing some of the deep-rooted issues that I have, as most of us have, so that I don't fall apart. Also on social media, Bebe Rexha, earlier this month the vocalist bravely sharing her diagnosis with her 1.3 million followers. I'm bipolar and I'm not ashamed anymore.
People are benefiting from celebrities talking about their conditions. The average person is more likely to see a professional about it.
And the hope now is that this new candor will help preserve the well-being of entertainers and the fans who look up to them. George?
It can make a big difference. Okay, Chris, thanks.
Wow. That was great how Selena Gomez opened up about the ordeal she went through. Yes. She is a great inspiration for other people who might be going through the same thing. Celebrities have a huge influence on the decisions people make. Do you agree?
Yes, I do. I urge everyone who has any of these symptoms to talk to their doctor about a treatment plan.
That's great advice. Thank you for being a guest on Let's Talk About It. Thank you very much for giving us all a better insight on depression and anxiety. I want to thank everyone for joining us on Let's Talk About It. See you soon. Goodbye, everyone.
Do you have something to talk about? Email your topic or video to Let's Talk About It. The email is listed below.